I started out quite simply. I was a poor boy in Smyrna, Tennessee, yearning to find some way up and out. The one and only Carol Channing came to Smyrna on a personal appearance tour. When I asked her to autograph my program, she wrote on it in red ink, "You belong in the theater. You have the eyes of a playwright. Stay creative and move to New York. You'll find what you're looking for in New York." I told her I wasn't creative. I had never created anything other than maybe a sandcastle, and I'd never written a thing. I wouldn't have time to create a play. She told me to close my eyes so I'd really hear what she had to say. Her words sounded to me like those of an oracle.
Create something every day. Creative work seems to heal everything. So when we create, even a sandcastle, we're closer to being whole and well.
When I opened my eyes, she was gone. Now, I'm going to ask each of you to contribute a story from your own life. We'll put your own stories on the stage. Why don't we start with you, Rocky?
Everything I am today, I owe to the greatest single figure in journalism. Sometimes, your whole life can be changed in just one magical moment. All due to the very special words of one very special person. May I tell you my story, how I found love and glory, all thanks to Miss Liz Smith.
Liz Smith.
I was just a hick kid, living in the sticks kid, down in Footville, Georgia.
Liz Smith.
I'd read her in the papers, read of stars and capers.
All along the Great Wide Way.
I'd save every penny, pal, can you spare any?
Saving up to someday take the train to Broadway.
Working after school at Vinny's Photoshop, I tell folks I won't stop until I reach the top.
He had a dream.
Someday Liz Smith will see me in a New York play, and then Liz Smith will say in her syndicated way,
"Dear readers, I won't soon forget my first encounter with an actor named Rocky Krieger of Naked Maids Dusting. I haven't had an experience like this since Spider-Man. I was moved to tears. Breathtaking, heartbreaking, astonishingly fantastic, an auspicious event."
I could see every detail of this recurring dream of mine so clearly, right down to the striking silver sequin Bob Mackie original gown that Miss Liz Smith would wear the night she discovered me. I knew this was an authentic psychic flash. Each week I'd read backstage and Variety, and just as soon as I see the role that's right for me,
he's heading straight for Liz and fame at NYC.
I study Tiger Beat real carefully,
learning just how to be a proper celebrity.
I'm striving in all my photos now for a sulking yet happy all-American bad boy look, midway between that of my two main role models, Nick Carter and Aaron Carter. I became the drama star of Footville GA. My drama teacher, he even built up parts for me. Whether we did Dolly, Gypsy, or Company, he'd write an extra songs for me. New songs I'd sing brilliantly. This is some kind of a moment. He felt I might reach heights in the business even he'd never reached. I just kept focused on Liz and my destiny. At age 18, I hopped the 703. Pennsylvania Station was waiting for me.